In this video, I'm going to teach you how to do a geometric pattern that you can put on high ticket items like duvet covers, shower curtains, and credenzas. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juno with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005. And in this video, I want to teach you some of the tips and tricks that I use. I recently made this video right here about high ticket price items, and that made me think of patterns because you put a lot of patterns on these high ticket price items like duvet covers and shower curtains and credenzas and things like that. All use patterns, even phone cases and pop sockets and tote bags and things like that. So there's a lot of things, a lot of print on demand products that use patterns. So one of the patterns that I've noticed recently when going to Target is this pattern that I saw on Lysol. You can see right here, this geometric pattern. And oftentimes I look at patterns, I love to look at patterns and think, how can I make this? So I'm gonna show you how to make this pattern in Affinity Designer, how to color it and everything, and then save it as an SVG and color it in Canva and Kittle. So we're gonna use a lot of the different apps here. I'm gonna show you step by step on how to do it and how to save it and how to color it. It's all gonna be in this video. You're gonna wanna stay till the end to see how it turns out, but let's start by going to Affinity Designer and showing you the process. So here we are on Affinity Designer. I have my artboard here. The first thing we're gonna do is just change the artboard size. So click on your artboard, go to transform. We're only gonna need it 1,000 by 1,000. So let's uncheck this and do 1,000. So once you got it 1,000 by 1,000 right here, let's go back and zoom in so we can scroll here. I'm holding down option and using my scroll wheel and then hold down space bar to kind of move things around. So option, you can scroll back as well. All right, next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna do a couple of circles. So do a circle, get the circle tool right here, or ellipse tool, I think it's called. All right, and then hold down shift to make a perfect circle. You can see right there, you can make it whatever it is, 200, whatever, doesn't matter the size of the circle right now. We're gonna click on this arrow, the black arrow right here, the move tool. We're gonna click on the circle, hold down option, and drag. So we're gonna drag it until this line reaches the edge here, but this one reaches there. So we're just kinda at a diagonal right there. You see that, where it's kinda crossing? And let it go. So you're gonna see an intersection right there. That's what we need. And we're gonna do intersection right here, intersect. And that's the size we need right there. So the next thing we're gonna do is draw a square. Use the rectangle tool, do like this, and square. And this square, we're gonna color a different color. So let's do, doesn't matter what color, just blue if you want. And let's put it in the back. And this one also shouldn't have a stroke on it. So let's do that. And let's make sure both of these are the same size. So let's do 100 by 100. Like that. And sew this one as well. 100. Tab 100, tab. So these two are the exact same size now. We're gonna grab this one and put it over here and make sure they're exactly the same alignment. So we're gonna do align center and align middle right there. All right, so let's zoom in so we can see what we're doing now. So we have two shapes. We have the square, let's go to the layers. You have the square and the curve, right? Now we're gonna want triangles. And the way we're gonna do that is we're gonna copy this rectangle. So we're just gonna hit Command J. You can see both of them there. Now, we're gonna take the bottom one here. We're actually gonna do both. Can we do both? Yeah, convert to curves. Okay, now we're gonna click on the bottom one, click on your node tool, and click on this bottom one and delete. So you can see that's the top triangle. This one right here, we're gonna do the same thing, but the opposite. So click on this with the node tool and delete. So now you have two triangles and that curve, right? So next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna move this here and let's change the color of this one too. So it can be whatever color, not the stroke. We're gonna do like that, good. So now that we have all of them, Let's do this. And right butt up right against there like that. No space, but we're gonna flip it. So like that. And we might have to, there we go. It kind of snaps. And if you have snapping on like I do, it should snap. And I think that's fine. All right. The next one we're gonna do is let's move this up and down like this, and it should snap and flip it. So now that we got this whole thing right here, we're gonna group it and we're gonna make this whole thing 100 pixels. So instead of 200, let's make it 100 and 100. Good. And we're gonna butt it up here against the top like that. And we should be able to fit 10 of these now in this 1,000 square. So hold down Option and Shift and wait till it snaps like that. And hit Command J, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And we should get it right there at the edge. And we'll do the same thing, select all of these and drag it down. Make sure it snaps right there. And we're gonna do this 10 times. So this one would be 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So you see how that works? So now we have this cool pattern right here. And just so that it's the right size, we're gonna make sure that it's 1,000 by 1,000. Cool, there we go. Very nice, and now it can be a repeated pattern. Now if we wanna color it like the Lysol where it's different colors, I'm gonna show you a different trick to do this. There's not a real simple way to do this, but we're gonna ungroup all of these. We're gonna start here, click that one, and go all the way down and select all of them. Or you can just hit select all, Command A. And we're gonna go here and ungroup all of them. So layer, ungroup all. And you can see it's ungrouped everything. And now we can randomly pick the colors. So let's find a color palette first. I'm gonna go to coolers.co. So here I am at coolers.co. This is where I love to pick colors. You can explore and find color palettes or make your own. Well, let's explore and find a cool one here. You can see all these are the trending ones and we can pick any one of these. I'm gonna pick one that kind of matches what we saw on the Lysol. That's more of a orangey red kind of thing. Maybe this one. I'll do this one right here. You can export palette right here and you can save it as a image. So let's do that. And let's just call it colors. Export. And what it saves it as is a PNG with these colors right here, the hex codes and everything. So I'm gonna bring this into Affinity Designer and we're gonna use it. So here I am back on Affinity Designer. I have my colors here from Coolers and this artboard that we just did. So I'm gonna copy this artboard. One way you can do that is hold down Option, click on Artboard, Option, Shift, drag. You don't need Shift, but I'm using Shift so that it's on the same alignment. So we're gonna color this one a different color. So let's close the first artboard and open the second one. That's this one right here, you can see. So I'm gonna use these colors. And one of the ways to do that that's really fun is to hold down Command and start clicking on random ones like this. So I'll just go in here and just start clicking on random colors, you know, throughout the thing. So just have a kind of a randomized version of it. And you can go back in and click different ones, but this is kind of a fun way to do it, to color. So once you pick all your random ones, use your color tool, your eyedropper, and just click on this and now click on it. So you can see it colored all these different colors. Now you could go in here and also click on these like this and just randomly pick colors too. And click on it. So this process takes a little while because you're gonna have to like pick different colors here and then pick this one. I wish there was a faster way to do it, but there isn't. So I'm gonna do this off screen and I'll show you what happens when I use all these colors. So it took me a little while to color these. I just used these 5 colors right here. You could use 6 colors. I think 5 to 6 colors are great. and just click on these, and you can see they're all this color palette. So the next thing I'm gonna do is save this as a SVG and bring it into Canva and Kittle and see how I can color it. So click on Artboard right here, go to File, Export, and right here it says SVG, Artboard 1, and hit Export. And we can title it whatever. I'm gonna just call it Color Pattern. And we're gonna pull this color pattern into Canva and Kittle. So first Canva, here I am on canva.com. We're just gonna create a new design. It can be whatever size. I'm gonna just do custom size, 4,500 by 5,400. We could have done that 1,000 by 1,000 as well, but we'll just enlarge it. So go to uploads right here and upload media. So I uploaded the color pattern you can see right here. Just click on it. And now we can stretch it like that. And again, you can change your artboard size to match, but I'm just gonna show you how you can color it, right? So you can see here are the five colors of my color palette, and watch when I go to styles. So now I can use these color palettes here. Let's use color palettes, see all, and look what happens when I click on color palettes. Isn't that cool? It changes the colors that I've used here. So you can try it out with different colors and have fun with this. So it all does it. And you can do it again, it still saves it. So this one might be cool, but if you go back to uploads, you can still upload your original one if you don't like the colors here. So I think that color is really cool. So what you can do now is if you like this color right here, you can export this with this new color and use it for Redbubble and other places that have products like Merch by Amazon, Society 6, all of those, and put it on the different products that have patterns on it. So phone cases and bags and shower curtains and all those home products. Let me show you how you can do it on Kittle in the same way. So here I am on Kittle, app.kittle.com, new project, I just started one. And if I go here and do uploads, I can upload the same thing, pick my upload pattern from your dropdown, and you can see all I have to do is click it on here as well. It's gonna remember the colors, take a little while, but I'm gonna stretch it out as well. So you can see it. And I'm gonna move my face because the color palette's below here, so let me get this out of the way. If I do this, now I can try their color palettes and check it out. Kind of some cool, more vintage looking color palettes. Right? And of course, if you go in here, you can change any of these colors to something different. So if you come in here and want to try different colors as well, it will change just those colors on the color palette. So you can make it lighter, darker, whatever you want. You want this darker color, more red, you can come in here, you know, and do like that. So have fun with this. A couple of ways where you can change the colors really easily. So have fun with this one. Put these patterns on different products and hopefully you get some sales. So I wanted to show you one last thing. This is the color that I have with Canva, the pattern that I made on Affinity Designer with the colors in Canva. You can see I brought it in as a PNG. I exported it as a PNG. And because it's a square, I can do some cool things with it. So you can see here, it fits perfect on here. But like the desk mat, for example, if I enabled this here, you can see it still needs to stretch out and I have it at 100%. So one thing I could do is make sure that it's bigger, or I could choose a pattern here and put regular grid, and you can see it just looks like it matches now and just continues that pattern because it has that regular grid. Or you can choose the offset grid and it does a different pattern here too, so it looks like it's totally different and you can't see the pattern. So that's a good compromise as well. Both of those work. And I can save my changes. And you can see it fits on duvet covers and shower curtains and all the new stuff here. Just so many products that you can put patterns on and change the colors too. So you can do this with different colors in Canva, just keep changing the colors and doing it. So have fun with this one. This is a cool one to have backpacks and leggings and duffel bags, and just Redbubble has so many products that you can do. So try it out, have fun with this one, put it on all the different products and try different colors. So that is it for this video. Thanks so much for watching. Hopefully this video was super helpful for you. If it was, make sure to give it a thumbs up. It really helps in the algorithm. And if you're not subscribed to this channel already, make sure to hit that subscribe button right there. The question of the day for this video is, what other patterns have you seen in stores? I saw this pattern in Target and wanted to do it. If you've seen another pattern that you like, let me know. Let me know in the comments. Maybe send me a picture of it if you can. That'd be really great. Or describe it in a good way in the comments, and I'll make sure to try and look for that and see if we can do a video about it. Thanks again for watching. And if you want to see more pattern videos, click on these right here. And always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.